So is America a divided nation? Welcome to this live studio audience edition of Hannity. Now tonight for the entire hour, we'll be tackling the most controversial issues facing the country, from race relations to Obamacare, immigration, and much more. No topic tonight is off limits, because as we've seen in the wake of the Zimmerman verdict, and even following the 2012 presidential election, there is a great divide that exists here in America today, and it's time to explore why. Now, in a few minutes, Utah Senator, Tea Party favorite Mike Lee will join us from Washington. He's going to tackle the sensitive issue of health care. And then a liberal and conservative collide when Juan Williams will square off with former Florida Congressman Colonel Alan West on the topic of race. But before we get to all of that, it's time to welcome in our brilliant studio audience who will be here for the next 60 minutes. Good to see you all. Welcome. All right, scale of 1 to 10, shout-out numbers. How divided is America? 10 being the most divided.
8.
8, absolutely.
8. Anyone say 10? 10. Noelle, why 10? Why?
You know, the reason I say 10 is because I think Barack Obama, when he got to be president, immediately started on class warfare and then immediately started with pitted the races. And I know Jamu's shaking your head, but it's true. We are more divided. Our nation is more divided ever since he took president. I think it's one of the worst things that's ever happened. And I feel that within people. I deal with donors. And I feel that with money. I feel that with race. I feel that in every aspect that we can. I think Obamacare, I think everything that he has done nothing but divide us as a nation.
All right, more numbers. What do we got, Tom?
Nine.
It's off the charts.
Off the charts. Higher than 10, yeah, if possible?
Yeah. And I agree with Nicole. Obama should be a leader. Playing a role of the leader. And unfortunately, I really don't think that he's doing that. He has injected the race card, the child welfare card, the grandma card, anything to push his big government agenda, because he believes more in big government than in the power of the individual.
Yeah.
That's the fundamental difference. The fundamental difference is Obama brought in huge government programs, and he's facing resistance for those of us who believe in individual liberty.
Isn't that what it comes down to? Statists want big government. Conservatives want limited government.
That's what the polarization
is about. Is it that fundamental?
No, it isn't, Sean.
It isn't.
We're all one America. You can have different views and disagree politely. Bill Clinton brought America together. Republicans like Ronald Reagan did. We are one America.
Doug, you just said 8 out of 10 were divided.
We are. The president and both parties have divided this country, but it doesn't have to be. Sean, we are the greatest nation on earth, and we're not a people that lack common values.
There might be some truth. All right, let me ask the next one. How many, on a scale of 1 to 10, blame Republicans for the divide? I know 10 out of you. All right, Jamu's a 10. Keisha, in the back, what?
Blame Republicans. I don't think we can blame liberals. I don't think we can blame our president. I think that he represents the majority, and the government is supposed to be for the people, not individuals.
He sets the tone. The president sets the tone. You dial this back to Obamacare, which was a huge government expansion. The president said, if you don't agree with me, you're misinforming people. That was creating a fear and a divide right there. If you don't agree with me, you're misinforming
people. Sean, the issue here is we've got a president who's acting very unpresidential. He needs to stop playing Barney Fife and cherry picking these little local crime stories, and he needs to focus on the big issues of the day. Stop dividing us, President Obama.
Jennifer Stefano is a Tea Party member. Jennifer.
Right. And I believe the nation's divided. It's about a 3, because I don't really believe we as Americans are that divided. What I believe is that some presidents bring out the worst in us. Lyndon Johnson is one that comes immediately to mind. Richard Nixon, another one. And Barack Obama takes the cake. They bring out the worst in us.
We're divided
in this room.
Look,
okay.
I agree. Today we're at a heightened stance of divide because of this Zimmerman verdict. And what I just saw there is unbelievable to me. Barack Obama, in a great political speech, and he's a terrific orator, and he could, you know, rebel rouse with the best. I mean, that was a great speech, talking about we're all one America. The speeches he's given on the heels of this verdict have been the polar opposite of what I've seen there. He's talking about this being a racially profiled. He actually opined, the president of this country said this jury's verdict was wrong, which is outrageous to me. Outrageous.
He said it was a racially profiled incident.
Jamu.
Look, as much as I love all of the folks in this audience, they are living outside of reality. This country has been divided.
Well, everybody here is outside of reality. Okay.
This country has been more divided at other times. We have to understand that our media has been democratized. Everything, all of the controversy, all of the division is actually taking place in high division. Billions of pixels of the hate and opinions and
hate?
People who have a platform who never
Florida
did before.
Is an apartheid state?
No. But there, that's the change from when we had Bill Clinton as president, when Ronald Reagan
Let
was
me give
president.
You an example.
It's not that we're
Hang
more
on.
Divided.
Let me give you
it's
an example.
That we all have platforms in which to
Let
express
me give you
an,
when the
our
president
divisions.
Say Republicans want dirty air and water. And that's not their plan. Or they want kids with autism, Down syndrome, and the elderly to fend for themselves. Big election issue. Is that divisive?
Well,
is that divisive?
Sean, what has been divisive with Republicans is that for the
I
first
asked
time,
that question.
For the first time, Republicans have gone into Congress and said, we are not going to govern. We get paid to come into this building, this beautiful Capitol, the Thank history God. Of our democracy,
You're
and we are
me
not
election.
Going to govern.
I'm going to ask the question
We're the
again.
Party of no,
when the
and that has never
Jamu,
been done in our history before.
When the president says that Republicans want kids with autism and Down syndrome and the elderly to fend for themselves. I asked if he was divisive, and you lectured me about Congress.
Sean, I'm a Democrat.
Congress hasn't done anything.
Divisive.
Congress refused to legislate. All they do is say no to this
president. Talking about Congress,
and
yes
Congress
or no?
has
yes.
never in the history of
you
America done
Doug
that.
Schoen,
the
Democrat.
Senate has
Look,
never
I'm a Democrat. He is divisive. It is very, very sad that he's not acting to unify the country. Lyndon Johnson passed the Civil Rights Bill. Come on, don't call him a bad person. We need people like that with big ideas and want to bring the country together.
There is a fundamental divide in this country. There are people who are fighting to restore constitutional principles, and there are people that are fighting to expand the role of government beyond its means. We have to recognize that. So there is a fight going on right now
you
between
see,
those two sides.
Let me agree with what Jedediah is saying here. Either you believe in bigger government, or see, I don't think this can be reconciled, or
exactly.
limited government. Jason.
It's not divided government per se that I think is the problem. It's the racial division, and again, I think the president sets the tone. He started at the top. And what's sad is that this president has not hesitated to divide the country by race when it suits his political needs, whether it's the calling voter ID laws racist or throwbacks to Jim Crow, whether it's using his administration to support racial admissions in college campuses and so forth. When it suits his purposes, he will divide the country by race. And Trayvon Martin was just the latest example of that.
Okay, yeah, back here. Go ahead. Yeah.
I think that bigger than a racial division, we have a generational gap. The people that are in position of power right now are what? Boomers. And then you have the millennials who are highly diverse. Almost 50% of them are multicultural in nature who think differently. I think it's going to take another generation to take positions of authority and power and representation for us to really get into a united America.
I worry, though.
We're not there yet, but the future and the changing face of America and the trends show it already.
All right, Lois, hang on. Kerry Pickett, Lois, a.k.a. Lois Lane.
Thank you very much. No, actually, you have to remember, this president, even before he got into office, he was actually pushing a lot of the racial divide. He did to Hillary Clinton. He pretty much accused her of being a racist during the primaries. Then when he got into office, what happened there? Skip Gate, remember him? He was the professor over at Harvard, and he had to have a big beer summit to actually try and
stupider.
Ended up clean that up. I mean, honestly, we really have to think about how this president has ended up using the whole like racism issue to try and also make looked at Tea Partiers as racist during the 2010.
All right, Basil. Let's get to Basil. He's a Democrat. We got
I find
time.
It amazing that we have conveniently skipped over all of the Bush-Cheney years. Did Bush-Cheney and Karl Rove as the enforcer not divide this country? And we talk about big government versus small government. How many of us are now benefiting from the fact that this president got the unemployment rate from over 10% down to under 8? We should all be thankful for that. We should all be thankful for that.
Talking about health care. Talking about health care.
We're going to get into that.
President Bush talked to me about personal responsibility for health care, fitness, exercise, cutting down on health care costs. Obamacare, by contrast, divisive, extending an entitlement. Let's take care of you. You'll get sick. Tremendous health care costs. We'll all take care of you. But what is it going to cost?
All right.
Not as much as
last word. Yeah, we have.
Every
I think we got everybody in.
Managed to pass major social legislation with bipartisan support, whether it was President Bush with No Child Left Behind, Medicare Part D, President Clinton with welfare reform. President Obama came into office with a kind of rhetoric that he was a uniter, but then he just rammed partisan legislation through Congress. That tone's been there since.
Healthcare
then.
Was rammed down our throat. All right. All right, guys, stay right there. We're now going to turn.